Hey guys, we're back on naval subject matter this week, taking a look at Dragon's 1/700th scale Z-31 destroyer kit. Let's open her on up and take a look. So, starting off, we've got a quad duplication set of various detail and munition parts for this kit. Again, since it is 700th scale, don't know how well camera's going to focus, but they're all very sharply rendered, especially for this small scale. Might be able to best see here on one of the cannon turrets. Again, this is very well done, especially for this small scale. Now, one thing about this particular kit I do like is that it does give you both options for waterline and full hull. So regardless of which way you decide to build her, either doing it in a little vignette at sea or just mount it on a stand, which it does come with, which go ahead and just show that now. No, pretty basic stand. You've got the option to do that. That is a definite plus that I give credit to Dragon for doing. Turning on, we have the main deck, as well as some of the other odds and end parts, riggings, masts, some of the structure, as well as part of the exhaust stack. Again, hopefully this will show up. There's a lot of fine surface detailing in here and along the deck. Again, because of the small scale, I don't think it's going to really show up on camera, unfortunately. But just believe that it's there. Again, rest of the other detail parts are nicely rendered, even just in plastic. One thing this set does come with is a little spur of road etch, which we'll look at in a few minutes. Oops. Turning on, we've got all of our mast parts and a couple little other odds and ends. Again, for the scale, I'm not going to complain too much, but nicely done there. Last sprue, we've got majority of our structure parts. Again, hopefully the detail is going to show up on camera. It's focusing. And here along the sides as well. Again, Dragon did a very nice job on this kit. I did not find anything really jumped out at me as being potentially problematic or too inaccurate for the scale. Obviously, though, with the amount of small parts you're going to be working with, it's going to be one you want to take slowly. Now, as I mentioned, it does include a threat of photo etch for things such as radar, some of the railings, and other odds and ends. And yeah, this is a nice inclusion. It would be nice if they also include the full railing, so you can do all the railings, but is what it is. I'm not going to complain that much. Just let you guys know about it. Single little decal sheet as well. Get our all the markings included. Now, as I stated, because of the small scale, you're going to want to take this slow, as you're going to be working with a lot of tiny parts, and if you rush it, you're liable to lose them to the floor monster. And we never want to feed that bugger. So it starts off building up all the sub-assemblies for the munitions, the cannons, torpedo launchers, etc. And then you move into building up the structure parts before moving on to finally getting the hull together and getting them all glued down. It does recommend two different marking options for two different deployments. One in late 44 and one in 43. So you do have some options. Obviously, if you're newer to ship models, I would recommend this later scheme since it's not as difficult. If you're more experienced, go with the more complex camouflage scheme. So, overall, for what you get in the box, this is a nice little kit. Again, I really didn't have anything that jumped out at me as saying, hey, this could be a problem. Just take it slow, and yeah, you shouldn't have that much difficulty other than just dealing with the small scale. So that was a look at Dragon's 1/700 scale Z-31 destroyer kit. Nice little kit that I really could not find that much to fault with. So until next time.